Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
As we know, today it is Father's Day. And we don't want to miss out on the mothers, because, you know, mothers are very important, too. They are the helpmeet of the father. So a very, very important connection there when it comes to marriage. So anyway, I'm Terry Brandon. I will be opening up our service today. And we do have a guest speaker, James Richmond, who is going to be speaking later today in the service. Really looking forward to this because it's going to be exciting, and I know he's going to do a wonderful job. Great message. God doesn't make mistakes. So we definitely know that. Well, let's open up with a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we just thank you that we are here to join today in just a wonderful time of worship. And Heavenly Father, we just want to glorify you because you are a Heavenly Father and we have earthly fathers here too, Lord. And we just thank you for the earthly fathers that are here to instruct their children. And we are thankful for the earthly fathers who were here and have gone on to be with you, Lord. And Heavenly Father, we just pray that you would send us the Holy Spirit, that you would just fill this sanctuary, that you would touch the lives of everyone in here, Father, and also those who are seeing this on internet, Father. We just pray, Lord, that you would just bless this service, that you would just bless the message that comes forth. You would touch the ears and the hearts of everyone, Father, and we just ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, I do have a few announcements, and one is, I'll get to one we all pretty well know, and that's the Bible study going on here. It's in 2 Corinthians. Just going to finish chapter 4, like the last two verses, and there's a lot of information on verses 17 and 18. You can read through it really quick, but there's a lot of interpretation and a lot of information about verses 17 and 18, and then if we do have time, we'll move on to chapter 5. So we're just really looking forward to that, and it's going to be pretty decent. So it starts at 6:15, where you can enjoy a wonderful meal over here at the fellowship hall. We never know each week what we're going to have, but it can be a surprise every time. And we've just really blessed those who prepare the food and wonderful desserts that come along with that, fruit, snacks. It can be a small little banquet sometimes when it gets going. At 6:30, though, we do start the Bible study, and then Pastor Tony does the children's church. Speaking of Pastor Tony and Carlene are not here today. They went to take some time to get refreshed and energized and to really have an exciting moment with this, so we're really looking forward. We thank you for all the guests that are coming in and returning folks. So we're really getting excited about this because it's a great time. You know, if you're not here today and you're just hearing this, it's so much more enriching when you're here live and in person because it's happening right now. It's going on. It's just a great time to be here. God wants us to be in fellowship. Fellowship is so important, even though we can fellowship over the internet and we can fellowship over our phones. It's not really being there. God touches us because he comes and puts his hands on our shoulders and he guides us. Isn't it a lot better that he's there with you than he's just distant off and, you know, you have to kind of wait your turn to hear from him? He's right there instantly. So it's a great time here. Okay, we're going to begin our service here in just a moment, but another thing I need to add, I've been talking about July 3rd and Calvary's love. As a result of the situation here, they've had to reschedule. We don't know when the next date will be. But apparently there was one of the singers was not able to make it for that day. And it's so much better when you've got the whole team of musicians together. So they've rescheduled, hopefully, for another time, hopefully this year at some point. But we also do have the Southerners coming in sometime around the fall, so we're going to really look forward to that. We'll be just really excited, but you never know what next music we may have here. But speaking of music, we're going to continue on now with our first song here, and Katie Richmond is going to lead us in this. We just ask her blessing on this and just welcome her as she comes up. Some of the dust cleaned off the keyboards there originally here, so We'll come back again. All right. Well, at this point, I'd like to have the children come up. I've got a special message for them. So if they could make their way up here and let's see. I think what I will do, so you can see their faces. Well, let's have them sit down in front of the table here on the floor. That means I'm going to sit down on the floor. Go ahead and have a seat. I was looking through a book and I came across an interesting book on 52 small children's lessons. And this one had to do with Father's Day, and I thought, this is just perfect. So we're going to have some fun with this one, and this will be good. So I'm just going to have a seat. I'll quickly get down and slowly get back up. All right. Hey, this is great that you guys are here. Yeah. I like your enthusiasm. That's great to see.
Yeah.
Okay, well, you know, today is Father's Day, and dads are pretty special about that.
Yeah.
Well, we're going to find out how special they are to you guys in just a minute here. So it's a good day to thank God for dads. You know, dads are pretty important because they like to build things. Some dads like to build furniture.
Yeah.
Some dads like to build houses.
Yep.
Some dads like to build cars. Well, I know we have a few fellows that like to work on cars and things like that. So it's pretty cool. So anyway, they do a lot of good jobs building stuff. So what are some things your dad's building? Or try to fix.
Yeah. TV.
TV. Okay.
TV. Great.
Anything else?
No, Samuel.
The TV. Is the TV the most important thing that you feel your dad fixes?
Yeah.
No, the set. The set of the set of the part to the TV that helps
he made a set that to the.
Yeah.
Oh, mounting the TV on the wall.
Yeah.
Okay. How big of a TV do you guys have?
75 inch.
Well, that's not too bad, is it? No. Does it take more than one person to lift it up there?
Yes.
Okay. Well, anyway, yeah, dads build some pretty interesting things, and you know, and then sometimes they sit back and they're just kind of how proud they are of that, and just put their feet up and think, man, this is great because I was able to fix this whatchamacallit or whatever it was that they were working on. So it's pretty important. Well, your dad is pretty proud of you too. So I have something here that, there we go. I've got something here that your dads are also pretty proud of too. And can you guys see this?
Yourself.
Yeah.
See that?
It's a mirror.
How about that? Can you see it? Thanks for letting the audience know. I appreciate that. So, yeah. You see yourself in here.
We see that.
Got that? I mean, you guys might look pretty small coming out from here. But, yes, our dads are really proud of you guys because, you know, that you guys are one thing that your dad is made perfect through God's help, okay? So let's promise today that we can make our dads proud of you guys. We know he is, and we'll also be proud of our Heavenly Father. So the Bible was given to us in order to learn to be better dads, and also there is a command in there that we need to honor our mother and fathers.
Yeah.
Very important there. So, I'm going to ask you, do you think you guys could help me with a pact here, with a kind of a verbal commitment? Mm-hmm. If you guys could follow along, repeat what after I said. Kind of quiet. What? What do you think? No. Oh, can you guys raise your right hand? Everybody raise their right hand here, or raise a hand.
Hey, you know which is right. That.
Okay, so you guys repeat after me. You ready?
Awesome.
And help our are ones that have some energy in here as well. So I promise. I promise.
I promise.
How long do you guys want to be here?
I don't want to be here.
Okay, we're ready. I promise.
I promise.
To be good for my dad.
To be good for my dad.
And I pledge.
I pledge.
All of my mental, emotional, and physical faculties. Can you get that out?
No.
All of my mental and physical faculties. To treating Dad with love, and I, say your name.
And.
You guys remember your name?
I, Jerry.
Okay.
No, not everyone.
Will, okay, you guys ready? We got a big word coming up here, so listen. I will never, not ever, willfully attempt to damage, here it comes, the aforementioned parental unit.
What is that?
What is that?
Aforementioned means that the actual form of the parental unit, in other words, you'll not damage the reputation of your mother and father. Affirmation. Okay, the parental unit. Okay? And I will love. And I will love my dad and thank God for him as long as I live. Okay. Pretty important. Try to remember that because your parents are teachers. And I know everything they do, whether it's right or wrong, you're learning from them, right? Well, you don't have to answer that. But your parents are there to watch over you. They're to honor you as well. Because, you know, for the father, he's the one that, and your mother there, you guys are perfectly made. Wonderful, you know, wonderfully made by God. So let's remember that. So let's close with a word of prayer here. We'll keep it short for our impatience. We're going to pray. Can you guys hold your hands? Okay. All right. Let's pray here. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for these children to be here, Lord. We just thank you, Lord, for fathers and mothers as well, because we know that with the parental unit, Lord, you have given this as an honor to human beings. And we should all respect that. And Heavenly Father, we just pray that you would bless these fathers today and these children that they have helped to make perfect. We ask all of this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
All right. Well, thank you very much for coming up here. I want you guys to jump on your feet while I grab my other stuff here. I'll give you some room.
Coming.
Oh, you're ready. All right.
Let's give him a hand.
Let's give him a round of applause. Well, it's always thrilling to have children up here, you know, and to see their faces, and you never know how they're going to respond. This is great. I'm glad we had the chance to do this. But as we get into Father's Day, you know, I think back on my father. I've heard a lot of people tell me that he was a bridge builder, being as he was with the Celina High School and the administration for over 30 years. He got to know a lot of families. So when he knew one student and he went on to be a father, the next child came along, he knew that family and that background there. But he always tried to help them in some way, how he could, whether it was through just some support to help with the family. When he was in the service, he was a physical therapist with that. So when he came back here, he would give his time to helping others who needed the physical therapy. some things that I enjoyed with is kind of strange, car washing. I always knew when it was going to rain because about the day after he washed the car, it was going to rain. So that was always an interesting moment there. Another time is we got to work on roofing the house. And that was kind of interesting. He made this special jig so, you know, that way the next shingle would come up and be exactly 5 inches above the other one there. That really worked out well. And I still use that little thing today. And of course, there was also times when, you know, I only got to do this a couple times, but my brother and my dad always liked to go hunting. And I think one thing that liked to place me in is that was right between my brother and my dad, and I was to chase out the rabbits. Thank goodness I never got shot or anything like that. But those are some things, just a couple things that I remember from my father. Fathers are really important in the aspect of raising families. And I just wanted to bring out a couple things here is that how Scripture helps us to learn more about fathers. And I'm going to read just a couple of these. It says, "Fathers must guard their own souls so they do not forget things of God, and are to teach them to their children and grandchildren." As I was reading through here, there was one word that came up quite a bit, and that is teach. And it's teach. You know, I was looking to find out, okay, you know, so you can get on these job searches and you can get on kind of the personality profile type things. And I was looking through there and I put in all the information here and it says, teacher. Okay. Well, I didn't really want to follow my father's footsteps on that because I didn't want to become a principal in that. So I would change the wording around a little bit and I'd put a little more information in and I'd click the button on there and all of a sudden come back up, teacher. Okay. Actually, I did this a third time, and it kept coming up, teacher. So I thought, okay, well, I think I know what I am to be by title. What I'm going to teach, I really don't know. So as my years went on, I ended up doing a lot of teaching in schools. I work with kids with disabilities. I work with kids with behavior problems. I work with adults with disabilities. And now I'm working with mental health issues. With kids and parents. It's interesting where God leads you, and many times, and especially with fathers, fatherhood, that position itself can be scary. You know, there's so many, you know, books out there we can look on, you know, parenting and how to raise children and bringing up sons, bringing up daughters. And I do have a few pages there if you're interested in finding out, hey, what can I do with my son, or what can I do with my grandson? I've got some books on here, 50 things you can do with boys, 50 things you can do with girls. So if you want that information, let me know. I'd love to pass it on here. We would be here for a while if I continued with that. But fathers are to teach their children diligently the things of God, no matter what they are doing. A lot of these come from the 4th, 5th, and 6th chapters of Deuteronomy. So another thing is really important if we're going to be fathers, if we're going to represent fatherhood, we need to go where our Heavenly Father put the instructions in, and that's in the Bible. Very important that we touch on those issues of the Bible. So I go through, I just want to find one other section here on this. It says, fathers are to respond to their children's questions about laws of Scripture explaining salvation to them. That's in Deuteronomy chapter 6. That Deuteronomy, those first two, those chapters 4, 5, and 6 have so much information in them. When it talks about the laws, laws are kind of Hebrew for instruction. Okay, so it talks about we need to give the laws, but we also need to give instruction. And does anybody know the second meaning of KFC? Kindness, firmness, and consistency. Fathers as well as mothers, we need to be kind when we give instruction. We need to be firm. And when it requires discipline, we also need to be firm in that as well. And it needs to be consistent. Fatherhood is really important. we're going to hear more about in our message today from James. But we're going to continue on now, giving you a moment to prepare for the offering. We're going to do an offering at this time. So I just like to give you a few minutes here to brush in your pockets or get things written out if you need to. Again, the offering, what comes in here goes towards just the usual typical things that we do here at this church, and that is we use electricity and we use water and other little necessary things that the church uses as we just go through each Sunday, day after day on that. So finances are very important to keep the building alive and allowing us to continue to come here and enjoy not all that hot weather out here, but also the comfort of being inside here. And, you know, sometimes we do get pretty comfortable here in the sanctuary, which is good. But then we also need to realize that the Holy Spirit comes and He fills our hearts, fills our minds, and we need to take those things as we leave and go back into that hot weather again and share it with others. That's pretty much what I wanted to cover today for Father's Day. And I wasn't sure how I was going to do this, but I had things right out here on my laptop. Didn't get a chance to print it out. So we're using a little bit of the electronics today. It's kind of exciting. And I accidentally read it because then I've got a little brighter light on here, so that helps out too. So let's just close with a word of prayer, and we'll get ready for our offering. Heavenly Father, we just pray that you would continue to give us the messages on fatherhood and also you, Heavenly Father. We pray, Lord, that you would bless everyone here as we continue. We pray, Father, that you would bless everyone when we depart today, but fill us, Father, with your will, your burning desire to serve you. And we ask this in Jesus' name. So let's go ahead and come at this time. James, if you could help me, and Steve, we could go ahead and take up an offering here, and it would be really great. Okay, let's bow in a word of prayer and thank all that's come forth. Heavenly Father, we just thank you that we have the opportunity to give back to you, Lord. Probably not as much as you have continued to give to us and more to come, Father. But we pray, Father, that all that comes forward, that you would bless the giver, that you would bless all that goes towards the purpose of this church, Father, and to be used for your glory and to go into heaven, Father. We ask all of this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Okay. While we are getting ready, taking care of the offering here, Katie, would you like to come up and we'll continue on with our next piece of music here?
Bye.
Katie, we really appreciate you with this opportunity here. Have we got another coming?
No.
No, okay. Okay. I'm just delighted to be able to introduce to you James Richmond. James is our guest speaker. And we'll just as well welcome him with our hands. We just ask that you give James some great support here. It is difficult when people come up here to speak, let alone give a special message. But God has blessed him with this message today, and we are going to have our ears blessed as well. So let's just sit back and enjoy James Richmond.
Well, thanks for having me. Nate and Holly have a whole lot of choice. Today on this Father's Day, we need to make sure we remember our fathers, whether they're with us or not. I'd like to say thank you to all the fathers out there. But thank you to my father as well. Thank you for being a protector, provider, for the guidance you've given me, for my knowledge of the Lord. I've been blessed with a good father. I've been blessed with some good sons. And hopefully God has blessed you as well. How wonderful it is to know that we have a God and a Father. We must continually keep His praise in our mouths. Our worldly fathers have made great contributions to us and our families despite challenges. Our worldly fathers have met our needs. They provided a comfortable life. They provided guidance. And they provided us with knowledge of the Lord, the gospel, His coming kingdom. As fathers, we should be providing examples for our children. Today is a day to remember the fathers who sustained their families, who remained with their families, provided for their families. And once again, I'd like to thank you. Our fathers are not always there. It could be days, weeks, years. We could go without seeing our fathers. But God's always with us. That Father is always with us. The Heavenly Father is always there. We can go to Him for prayer. We can go to Him for protection. We can go to Him for blessings. It's easy to compare the love we have as fathers with the love God has for us. Our earthly fathers love and care for us. Most fathers, they would die for their children. And is it possible to love anyone more than that? The Bible says it's possible. The Word says it's possible. Romans 8:32 says, He that spared not His own Son, but delivered Him up for us all, how shall He not give us all freely all good things? Excuse me. Through the sacrifice of His Son, God proved that He loved us beyond anything we could ever comprehend. Could you imagine giving your own child as a sacrifice for the sins of humanity? It's hard to comprehend and imagine such things for humans. Fortunately for us, that is a choice we won't have to make. God made that choice for us. And through Jesus, we can have eternal life. We can have peace. We can have rest. We can have that promised mansion. We can have that inheritance of God. From our Heavenly Father, we will receive an eternal inheritance, a heavenly inheritance, a non-perishable inheritance. Becoming a father and having a fatherly love can help us realize the love that God has for us. I was just telling Terry last night, as a child, it's hard to understand when your parent tells you this is going to hurt me more than it hurts you. You can only understand that as a parent. You only understand that one if she's on the other foot. You only understand, excuse me, I have a hard time reading my own handwriting. Fatherhood can teach us about the things that matter. Fatherhood can teach us about God. In a lot of ways, our worldly fathers emulate the love that God has for us. But we must remember that God's love is greater. In Psalms chapter 68, verse 5, God promises to be a father to the fatherless. If your father has passed, he isn't around for whatever reason, we just need to open the door to God, the Father, the Heavenly Father. We need to know that he can take care of us and provide all things. He knows what's best. And even if your father wasn't there, you lost contact with him with a disagreement, or maybe he passed on, God will be that father you need. And John chapter 14, verse 18 says that he will not leave us as orphans. And as fathers, we must remain vigilant. We must be spiritual guides to our children, the same way God guides us. We need to be that positive influence. The world has its influence through movies and shows, music. The schools have their influence. The media, they have their influence. But it's our responsibility to present a positive influence. It's our responsibility to teach our children the ways of God. As fathers, it's our duty to teach our kids to respect others, respect themselves, do what's right, treat others the way they want to be treated, and to teach them the ways of the Lord. The world, it has its influences, and we need to start having our influence. A lack of fathers is plaguing our world. You can look around and see that. There's a pandemic. It's not a coronavirus. It's a lack of fathers. Lack of a fatherly influence is affecting every segment of our human population. Every father, they make mistakes, and they're going to make mistakes. They're human. Because they are human, they're going to make mistakes, but at least they're trying. Our earthly fathers may make mistakes, but God doesn't. He's perfect in all his ways. And how important is it to have an earthly father? Has God blessed us to have an earthly father that loves and cares for us? I know I'm blessed to have one, and hopefully you are too. You had a good father, and you had a good relationship with him. Statistics show that you're living a better life than people that didn't have a father. The lack of fathers is devastating to society, and the statistics can show us that. And I have some statistics here from the Census Bureau. They're pretty eye-opening, and according to them, one in four children live without a father in the home. And that's just here in America. The statistics show us the negative effects of fatherless households. Four times more likely to live in poverty, more likely to have behavioral problems, more likely to go to prison. And if you have a girl in your household, they're seven times more likely to get pregnant as a teenager. As a father, we need to realize our positive influence. And the best way to do that is by teaching the ways of the Lord. Encourage them to study the Word. Children who are taught and practice the ways of the Lord are not running the streets. They're not shooting up schools. They're not victimizing their fellow man. We need to teach them about Jesus, teach them about the commandments, teach them to respect each other, teach them to respect themselves. wasn't for God, we wouldn't even have a father. God is above all. What makes a good dad? Can being a good dad get us into heaven? Well, as we know, the only way to get into heaven is through Jesus. Amen. You can't get in by being a good dad. You can't get in by being a good child. Doesn't matter if you're Mother Teresa. You don't believe in Jesus, you're not going to heaven. We're not teaching our children about Jesus. We're not doing our duty as a father. You can teach your children everything you know, send them to school, send them to college. Maybe they come back as a doctor or a lawyer. Then they make you proud. But what really matters is Jesus. What really matters is eternity. What really matters is where we're going to be spending our eternity. The education, it's not going to matter. The money's not going to matter. None of it is going to matter in the end. Eternity with our Father is the only thing that is going to matter. Our knowledge, our wealth, our bodies, they're not going to last. But we have the blessed hope of Jesus, who promised us eternal life. We have to teach that Jesus is what matters. He's the only hope in earth and in heaven. The love our Heavenly Father has for us is ever enduring. It's infallible. It's hard for us to grasp the concepts that are difficult to understand, let alone utilize it in our own lives. I have a devotional here I got from online. I'm giving an example of someone who forgave and showed us how to love God's way despite this horrific thing that had happened to him. The excerpt's called The Father's Love. There was a man from a small town. He had a son who was a soldier. The man's son was brutalized and killed in the war. This left the father heartbroken, and he said he would like to meet the man responsible for his son's death. Why do you think it was that he would want to meet these men that brutalized and killed his own son? It wasn't for revenge. He wanted to show these young men what it like to have somebody, what it would be like to have someone who loved them and cared about them. The father of the deceased soldier said he would like to take these young men out fishing, hiking, hunting, the things he would do with his own son, the things that he would be able to do if he wasn't taken from them. The father's heart was heavy with loss, but he forgave. Under those unthinkable circumstances, the man was still able to forgive his enemies. This man's response is an extraordinary one, and it's a godly one. The man's response can show us two things. One is that the earthly love is powerful and precious influence. And the other is realizing that we are called to love just as God loves us. And how does our Heavenly Father love? Well, 1 John 4:9 tells us that this is how God showed us his love among us. He sent his one and only Son into the world that we might live through him. God loves us of our own free will. We don't have to earn his love in any way. God wants us to love like he loves. Not just love our children, not just love our friends or family or the ones close to us, but everyone. God wants us to forgive. He wants us to pray for those that are against us. He wants to love. He wants us to love those who hate us. These are God's ways of loving. We should be teaching this way of love to our children. This is the way of the Heavenly Father. And remember, while we were yet sinners, Christ still died for us. He prayed for his tormentors as he hung upon the cross for our sins. That's love. That's the Savior we follow. That's the Messiah. He will make us whole again. That's our King. And we will see him when he returns in the clouds with great glory. He is our shepherd. He is the one who will be keeping us, and he is the one who will fulfill all his promises. Claim your heavenly inheritance. The only thing that can keep you from your heavenly inheritance is yourself. Accept the pardon Jesus laid down his life for. Accept his grace. Believe on his name. Follow his commandments and enter into the kingdom of heaven. That's your inheritance. The Lord said it would be so, and he is the same then, now, and forever. Your inheritance awaits. It just needs to be accepted. Have you accepted the Lord? Have you accepted your inheritance? Have you accepted that he rose again, victorious over death, hell, and the grave? He's coming back again, and by the way it looks, it's going to be sooner than later. Now I'd like to say thank you to our Heavenly Father. A happy Father's Day to our Heavenly Father. Thank you for protecting us. Thank you for our health. Thank you for my shelter. Thank you for my food. Thank you for my water. For all the blessings he's bestowed upon us. We wouldn't have anything if it wasn't for the Lord. To sum this message up, I'd like to say it's an admirable thing to be a father, as long as you're doing it the right way. I'd like to say thank you for all the fathers out there who are doing so. That's your worldly love. That's your fatherly love. Try God's love, his spiritual love. Love your children and love your neighbor as thyself. And that's what I got for you. I'd like to close in a word of prayer. Thank you, Father, for blessing me with this message. It may have been short, but hopefully it made the point. Please, Father, bless everyone that is here today. Bless this congregation. Bless this church. Bless Pastor Tony. Bless Carlene. Watch her and protect her health. Please, Father, help this church to grow and prosper. I'd like to ask all these things in the name of your Son, Jesus. Amen.
Absorb into our ears and into our hearts here. So. Well, that was great. One other thing we are going to do today before we close our service is we have an honor of awards here for fathers. And I'm going to let Katie and James, you going to help with this? Or Katie, have this in hand?
I can, yeah.
Okay. So if you want to announce what the awards are for, we'll just let them take over here.
I believe the first award we're going to have is the oldest father. So I don't want to put anybody on the spot here, but who would be the oldest father? Steve-O?
He's older than him. Are you older than him?
He's older than me.
Oh.
youngest?
The newest.
Oh, okay. And the next award will go to the newest father, and I do believe that is Ben Richmond with baby Ezra. Baby's first father day. Blessing and bless your family as well. And then we got some goodie bags for the rest of the fathers out there who are feeling left out. Happy Father's Day to you all. Thanks for enduring with me through that message. It was my first, so please don't think badly of me. All right, I'm going to hand it back over to Terry. Thank you, Terry.
Thank you.
Yep.
Well, I hope all the fathers in here feel pretty important, because regardless if you received anything, you are important in God's eyes. So do remember that. Remember the instructions that James mentioned that came from the Bible. Very important. Without those instructions, we wouldn't be able to be the fathers that we need to be today. This world has so many challenges in our lives that we can't catch up with anything new that keeps coming up our way here. But if we stand firm on God's word, right there is your foundation. Best way to go on that. Now let's close with a word of prayer. And James and Katie, why don't you guys go ahead and be back there so you can be greeted by the congregation as we depart today. Let's bow in a word of prayer, please. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for this opportunity to share your word with others, Father. We pray, Father, that you would continue to give us the faith and desire and determination to also spread the word to others. May the fathers spread the word to their children. Mothers spread the word to their children, Father. And we just pray that You have given us the blessing of marriage, Father, and we just thank you, Lord, for honoring that, and we pray, Lord, that we would represent that with honor as well. Heavenly Father, we just ask that if any hearts in here have been touched by this message today, that you would allow them to seek your word, to seek the scriptures, Father, for additional information, Lord. We know every bit of information and anything that we need to know is there. Help us, fathers, to be doers of your word. We pray, Father, that if anybody needs prayer today, we would just ask, Lord, that if anybody is ailing or having struggles with their marriage, Father, we pray that you would just bless those and strengthen those, Father, who feel like their marriage is strong, but continue, Father, to reinforce it, Father, because there is so much temptation around us. There's so much world, secular influence that we so many times get distracted, or whether it would be on TV or just out in the community, Father. We pray, Lord, that you would give fathers the opportunity to share their experiences and their challenges with others. We pray, Father, that these fathers would be accountable to each other so they could stand firm on their faith, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for the mothers and spouses that are there to support them, Lord, because they are so needed. We just thank you that marriage is an accountability group with that. Father, we just pray that you would bless this congregation as we depart today, and we continue to be used by you for your glory. We are the vessels that you use each day, Father. We are fragile, but Lord, we know that you continue to build the inner man inside of us, Father. And we just ask all this in Jesus' name. Guide us, protect us, and keep us safe. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Yes. And thank you, everyone, for coming today and giving Mr. James Rivsham the opportunity to share the word. Thank you very much. Yeah.